Welcome all to yet another video, Dr. RS and you, on the science of cosmetics and personal care products. So my name is Ramesh Surya Narayan, and you can type in YouTube video SURIA, no IYA. So IA, right? You can type this in the YouTube videos. You will get it as Dr. Ramesh Surya Narayanan. All my videos regarding this topic, and my email ID is ramesh.narayanan@gmail.com. Okay, today we are in part 116, herbal cosmetics. We will briefly see about three herbs: aloe, turmeric, sandal. Right, basically for its skincare applications of aloe, turmeric, and sandal. So whenever this is for an examination point of view for a student, right? There is a certain aspect when we discuss about any herb, we have to first name the herb, then the part used in the herb in the cosmetics, then the family, the species, the family of the herb, then the chemical constituents and the application of the herb in cosmetic industry. That is how very briefly we have to structure every herb, writing about every herb. In this three videos, I'm going to cover some seven to nine herbs we will cover. So now here the chemical constituents which I am going to give is very, very brief, no? So now I'm just giving the chemical constituents which is widely attributed for the function of the herb, right? But see, for a starter, you can take those chemical constituents and progress, right? But I'm going to put a video on the herbal research, right? How we can progress on herbal research. In that herbal research, what I will do is, what are the current ways in attributing the herbal constituents and the phytoconstituents of the herbs, and then how this has to be modified to get the full functional benefit of a herb. No, this, how the approach can be different. So that we will discuss separately, but in this chapter 116, 117, 118, part 116, 117, and 118, we will discuss two to three herbs in each, which just gives the introduction about the herbs, right, and its application in the cosmetic industry, right? It's just to introduce, right? The first herb we will be discussing is the aloe, the gel from aloe leaf is widely used. So, in that way, aloe gel is used, and aloe gel is obtained from the leaves of various species of aloe like aloe barbadensis, aloe ferox, family liliaceae, found in South Africa, West Indies, and India. So this is the aloe. So we will see very briefly the chemical constituents and application of the aloe gel in cosmetics. We saw this aloe vera gel from aloe leaf is used in cosmetics. Aloe leaf produces two substances. This is very important: gel and latex. So aloe gel is a clear jelly-like substance found in the inner part of the aloe plant leaf, right? Aloe latex comes from just the base of the leaf and is yellow in color. Some aloe products are made from whole leaves, whole crushed leaves, so they contain both gel and latex. So, for our purpose, cosmetic purpose, The most important thing is the gel. No, not the latex. Right? We need the gel. The latex contain anthraquinone glycosides and used medicinally as laxatives. So, it is not used in cosmetics. It is used in pharmaceuticals as laxatives. Anthraquinone glycosides. The latex is not used for cosmetic skin care. Pure aloe juice for skin care should be free or should be very low in anthraquinone glycosides content, since higher levels of the ingredient in aloe juice make the gel off-white to brown in color and also sometimes can impart irritation when used in skin care products. So, aloe gel is obtained from the aloe leaf. So, we have to be very careful. The aloe gel is obtained from the inner part of the leaves, no? Middle part of the leaves. Base of the aloe leaf, you get yellow color latex. And the constituent of that latex is, anthraquinone glycosides, which is more used as a laxative in pharmaceutical preparations. So we can't use, that is, if the aloe gel is contaminated with this anthraquinone glycosides, the latex, the gel can become yellow in color and also it can impart little irritation to the skin. So good aloe gel should be almost clear gel, right, without the color, without that off-white tinge, right? So the aloe gel, right? Now, what are the constituents of the aloe gel? The main constituent of the aloe gel, which gives its moisturizing and healing property, is the carbohydrates present in the gel. That is pure mannan, acetylated mannan, acetylated glucomannan, glucogalactomannans, galactan, galactoran, so then xylan, so and saccharides, also mannose, glucose, L-ramose and altopentose. If you remember, you can say mannans, then mannose, glucose, right? Then constituents, water, polysaccharides, amino acids, inorganic compounds, mineral, lipid, sterols and enzymes, right? Here I have explained each and everything, but you have to remember these things, of which what is more important for the aloe benefit is the polysaccharides. No, polysaccharides gives that moisturizing. It can moisturize the skin exceedingly well, and so that is how the aloe juice works. And carbohydrates and saccharides. Okay, carbohydrates and saccharides. Of course, enzymes and amino acids, inorganic compounds are at much lower level in aloe gel compared to carbohydrates and saccharides. Right. So, the chemical constituents, you have to write water, polysaccharides, amino acids, inorganic compounds, mineral, lipids, sterols and enzymes. And if you can mention some of the carbohydrates, right, this is also carbohydrates, right, these are all polysaccharides, saccharides and polysaccharides, right, and these are the main functional phytoconstituents of aloe. What are phytoconstituents? I'll take some time here to explain. See, for example, when you say aloe is working, see, aloe juice is very good for the skin. It, what is it? The chemicals present naturally in a herb is called the phytoconstituents. Okay, that is called the phytoconstituents. The phytoconstituents present in the aloe juice contributes to the functional benefit of the aloe juice. So right, so we will come later when we do on the advanced research, how can we approach to the research of herbal products, how these the active should be standardized, these actives should be standardized for batch to batch consistency in the potency of the herbal extract. Those are all the advanced topics which we will discuss later. Now, subsequently, after discussing the herbal ingredients, just take the herbal ingredients which I am mentioning and then just contemplate within yourself, no, how the herbal actives act. So this is the constituents of aloe. So aloe vera gel is used in products like skin moisturizers, face washes, body washes, face masks, sunscreen preparations. Aloe gel, because of the presence of polysaccharides, have skin moisturizing properties. There are reports of aloe gel soothing sunburnt skin. It gives a soothing feeling to the sunburnt skin. It has potential wound healing benefit, skin anti-aging benefit and anti-acne benefit. There are some reports on these additional benefits of aloe gel, and its main function is skin moisturizing properties. And because of the skin moisturizing properties, it soothes, it gives a soothe feel on sunburned skin, right? And wound healing benefit, right? So this is the function of aloe. So when we say the herb, we have seen what part of the herb is used, what is the family, what is the species, what are the chemical constituents, and what is its function, right? The second herb we will be discussing is turmeric. So turmeric powder is used, and extracts of turmeric powder is used. Basically, turmeric is prepared from the rhizome. Rhizome is underground stem, right? Rhizome of Curcuma longa Linn family Gingiberaceae, right? Found extensively in India, China, Indonesia and other South Asian countries, right? This is how the turmeric and turmeric powder, right? Now we will see the very briefly the chemical constituents of turmeric and its application in cosmetics. Turmeric, there are 235 phytoconstituents isolated from turmeric, right? The rhizome or root of turmeric, it's the underground stem. It's actually underground stem. It should not be called as root. For some clarification, some book says root. It's the underground stem of turmeric is the part used medicinally. We saw that. The main constituent group are polyphenolic curcuminoids, which include curcumin, which is very widely spoken about, D-methoxycurcumin, bis-D-methoxycurcumin and cyclocurcumin. This is the yellow pigment. Curcuminoids represent 2-5% of the root or the rhizome, typically composed of 85. In this 2-5%, 85% is curcumin, 10% D-methoxy curcumin, and 5% as bis-D-methoxy curcumin. Right? So curcumin is the most well studied constituent of. Curcumin is the most well-studied constituent of the turmeric. Curcumin is the most well-studied constituent of turmeric, right? Turmeric also contains sesquiterpenes, turmerone, atlantone, gingiberone, turmerol, germacrone and bisaboline. It also contains carbohydrates, proteins and resins. Right. So now, again, I'm insisting in this fact, turmeric contains 235 phytoconstituents. And of that, mostly curcumin as a indeed as a phytoprinciple from turmeric is well studied for its benefit. But what about the other ingredients present in that? How they synergize with curcumin to give the benefits? These are all the areas which have to be which are to be explored further to have more in-depth knowledge on the how the totality of the herb can be used. No? Isolating curcumin alone from turmeric and giving it for its benefit is like a chemical from herb, that's it. But how the phytoconstituents, specific phytoconstituents of the herb work together for the benefit, that has to be studied. But that approach we will see, we will brainstorm later. So now this is the, so it contains 2 to 5% curcuminoids, that you have to understand. The turmeric powder has 2 to 5% curcuminoids, and it also has sesquiterpenes, then carbohydrates, proteins and resins. These are some of the sesquiterpenes, right? Curcumin possesses antioxidant, antimicrobial and anti-inflammatory action. It also helps in depilatory action. Therefore, it is used in cosmetic creams for these benefits. Turmeric is used in facial mask, face washes and face creams. Right? So, this is turmeric, right? So, turmeric is widely used in cosmetics as a functional ingredient. Third herb we will be discussing is about sandalwood. Sandalwood powder and sandalwood oil is used widely in cosmetics. Sandalwood oil is obtained by distillation of the heartwood of Santalum album Linn family Santalaceae. So the heartwood is used, either the powder directly or the sandalwood oil is used in cosmetics. Santalum album is Indian sandalwood, right? Santalum spicatum is Australian sandalwood, right? Santalum spicatum species is Australian sandalwood. Sandalwood from southern India is of highest quality. Government of India control the harvest of sandalwood in India. Right? So, this is how the sandalwood tree looks like, and this is the sandalwood. Let us see very briefly the chemical constituents of sandalwood and then its application in cosmetics. Composition of sandalwood oil. The volatile or the essential oil of the sandalwood. The basically essential oil is different from fixed oil. Coconut oil, sesam oil, they are all fixed oils. When you put a drop on the paper, it stains the paper. But essential oils, when you put a drop on the paper, it slowly evaporates, right? That is volatile oil. Usually they are called essential oils. Contain about 95% of 2 isomeric sesquiterpenes, sesquiterpene alcohols, alpha and beta xanthols. Santals are responsible for the pleasant odor of sandalwood oil. Right? Also, 2 furfuryl pyrrole contribute to the odor. Additionally, the oil contains santalal, santin, santinone, tertiate santal, santalone, and santaline. So when you do GLC of pure sandalwood oil, okay, naturally you see a lot of constituents, but these are all the major constituents, right? So nature, it's very difficult to get the nature in a synthetic way, because from nature it is so many finer ingredients, phytoconstituents that constitute to the fineness and of the odor, right? And of course find the efficacy in a pharmaceutical herb, right? So now sandalwood oil helps to heal scrapes and cuts. Sandalwood has antimicrobial properties, making it popular herbal antiseptic for treating minor skin abrasions. It helps heal cuts, scrapes. Sandalwood oil known to lighten skin scars, marks, spots. Sandalwood oil can reduce acne and pimples. Sandalwood calms itchy, irritated skin. Sandalwood oil is a good in massage oils and in aromatherapy. Sandalwood oil is good in massage oils and aromatherapy. Have calming and relaxing effect. Used to combat stings and insect bites. Used as fragrance in cosmetic products. Used in facial creams, masks, face washes, soaps and talcum powders. Sandalwood's most important uses is to sedate the nervous system. Most important use is to sedate the nervous system. Subduing nervousness, anxiety, insomnia, and to some degree reducing nerve pain. Researchers have found it relaxes brain waves. So all these things, you know, you don't apply 100% sandalwood oil on your skin, right? It is very, very dangerous. Okay, you have to. You can just apply sandalwood powder. See, lot of sandalwood powder in the market. Whether they are genuine or not. No, it is very difficult. Most of them are not genuine. They get some wood powder and then mix synthetic sandalwood perfume and they sell it as sandalwood powder. So, first of all, you have to get the genuine sandalwood powder, genuine sandalwood oil, and then you can't use sandalwood oil as such on the skin. No, it is very, it can be dangerous. So, you have to make preparations of sandalwood oil, right? And along with the other antiseptic ingredients, you can use it. So, in a cosmetic product as a perfume, or to give the as an aromatherapy, it's okay. But to heal wounds and abrasions, you don't use it yourself. It has to be prescribed by Ayurvedic physicians or dermatologists. So don't use yourself to heal burns and cuts using sandalwood oil, right? That is not the, it should not be done, right? So sandalwood oil, you can use it for its relaxing effect in aromatherapy and as a fragrance and for its benefits as a, in the cosmetics, right? At low doses as a perfume, right? And that is this sandalwood. So today we have seen three herbs. In this section we have seen three herbs aloe, turmeric, and sandalwood. Right? Most of them are used for skin care benefits. In the next section, we will see some herbs, two or three herbs that are beneficial for hair care. Right? So, you can Google and find out products that has sandalwood oil, the numerous products that has aloe and the products that have turmeric, and then you can just, if you are interested, you can go through and read more. So again, I am repeating, when we come to the approach to herbal research, you know, we will discuss about how these herbs can be effectively used for the cosmetic and medicinal benefits, right? Thank you for listening to me in this video. Till we get connected in the next video, be happy, be safe, be healthy. Bye.